Right, very good. Good morning to everyone. So today we are going to discussing about the next topic of the chapter 1, unit 3, the topic data center technology. So as the same style, yesterday we have completed the last class about the broadband networks and internet architecture. Let me have a glance what's the stuff we are going to be talking about in DCT, that is data center technology. We'll talk about the virtualization followed by the standardization and modularity. All this are the components and the features of this DCT. The third stuff we'll talk about the automation. The fourth we'll talk about the remote operation. Fifth we'll talk about the highly availability. All some sort of the features like security aware design, operations and management, facilities, computing hardware, storage hardware, network hardware, and other some sort of consideration will be seen. If you see background of this image, which is yours showing here in the slide, it is the first layer. Top is the cloud storage and data encryption and data center. So in this, between these two processes, where the data center is here, if you observe carefully in the figure, in the backend figure is a data center. So in this data center, and here we have the cloud storage, and in between we have data, that is encryption. So all these features, the components will be act in between these two parts. Okay. So let me have start the difference between the cloud and data center. Before going to that one, let me see the definition of data center means what. The name indicates center means what? Some area where we can store some sort of data. So the definition is talking about it exists and specialized IT infrastructure is exclusively talking about the infrastructure point, that is IaaS. Now used to what purpose? Center means like we can call as a house, or is a house centralized one. It's not a decentralized one. Can we monitor from only one location? That is one point we can access. Inside that infrastructure, we have the IT resources, such as we can maintain the servers, we can maintain the databases, we can maintain the networking, we can maintain the telecommunication devices and software system. If you observe closely, the definition is talking about little bit of closer to the definition of cloud computing. Only the difference, if you see here, now data center is clear, right? So data center is called as a IT infrastructure, like we are going to using as a housed centralized, and which consisting of some IT resources, such as all this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now let me have a difference between the cloud and data center, where it differs between the cloud. Cloud also we are talking about for storage, data centers also talking about data storage. Now it is off premises. We talk about the cloud is off premises. It is on premises. So both are going to be handling. It is going to be focuses on hardware that stores data within an organization's local network. Mainly data centers, it's talking about the hardware part and storing part. Whereas it is a on premises data center, and cloud is going to be on off premises, talking about the computing. The computing that stores, where in the data centers we doesn't having any sort of the computing. Here we are going to have the computing in cloud, that is stored via the internet. The second difference is cloud services are outsourced to this third party. Here data centers are typically run in in-house IT department. Like every organization, they have individual data center. They are running in-house IT department inside that, their own resources. But here in the cloud services, we can have a third party cloud providers where we can perform all updates and ongoing maintenance will be done. So this is the exact difference between cloud and the data center. Both are for storage purpose. Cloud is off premises, data center is on premises. Cloud is going to deals with the computing, where the data center is not deal with that. And cloud computing is deal with the third parties where we can have do some different provide services. Whereas data centers is exclusively for one organization, one in-house department. Okay, coming to the first stuff of this data center technology is virtualization. This is the first one. So hope already we have discussed in the unit one about this virtualization clearly. But here the data center consisting of both physical and virtual IT resources. If you see left hand side, the figure, it is talking about here the virtualization, the virtual servers, and here the physical server. Here the physical servers and here the virtual server. Now to make this physical servers as virtualized, we are going to using hypervisors. So already we have discussed about this hypervisors. Now to connect off all this, we are going to using this switches, and also we are going to using this virtual the image VIMs, VIMS already we have seen in the experiments of S3 and EC2. VIM we are going to using this. Now this physical server and this virtual servers, we are making this both. These data centers are not give access directly to the physical server. They are going to creating some virtual servers, because any failures to access multiple persons, same resources going to be accessing by the multiple person, they are going to be creating this different virtualizations so that they can access from there easily. So the second point we're talking about is virtualized components that are easy to allocate, operate, release, monitor, and control of all this. So this figure already we have discussed in the left hand side from the starting of the unit one. And so data center is consisting of both physical and virtualized IT resources. Now coming to the second stuff in the data center virtualization, data center technology, that is the second stuff, stuff two, standardization and modularity. Modularity, we can say, is dividing the tasks, and we can reduce the burden and dividing a big program into smaller programs and reduce the, and after that we can integrate it. So the main focus of modularity and standardization are the key requirement for reducing of investment on operational cost. As we discussed earlier, Amazon doesn't having any infrastructures in multiple locations. Without that, directly from the cloud environment, they are going to be operating without the less investment, they are going to operating that. So we can reduce the investment as well as we can reduce the operational cost by enabling this economics of scale for procurement without any, we can reduce the cost in the procurement, like we can call as the tables or the ACs or the infrastructure which we required for that. And we can also reduce the acquisition, can also reduce the deployment cost and operation and maintenance cost as well. So consolidated of this all IT resources can serve different systems and can be shared among different cloud consumers. Like as we just now seen in the virtualization, with the help of hypervisors, we are going to be making that physical servers, making as a different systems with the help of virtualization, different system, and we can give access to multiple cloud consumers. The best example, if you see in the figure, this is the first stuff, virtualization, second stuff, standardization. Next, third stuff, we are going to be talking about automation. All combination of these three features, these three may be called as features and components combined, we can reduce the cost here. The cost is reducing and the flexibility is going to be increasing. Okay. And the third stuff, as I discussed, that is automation. Automation talks about, we are going to making automation. What is the use of automation when the data centers make automation? So we can specialize this platform so that provisioning, those who have, whoever wants these services, which type of services, which type of resources they want to access, we can make some customized one, that is provisioning, configure, patching, and monitoring without any supervision, without any administrator. Directly, if you have an automation, directly based on that membership, say for example, if you have a subscription of AHA, it may be how go for a 1 month subscription, or we can go for a 2 month subscription, or for 3 month subscription. Based on that provision of the user, you can configure your own. You can go for the configure and you can update. Patching in the sense means what? When you have dealing with that, every time we are getting the updates from the different softwares, we can done it and monitor without any supervision. So advances in data center management platforms and tools can be automatically computing technologies. The conclusion of the automation is the self-configuration and self-recovery can be done easily. So if you see the figure, from the good data, it is making reporting and transparenting and standardizing. At the last, it is giving self-service. Means without any supervisions, without any administrator, directly we are going to be have access the self-configure. We can ourselves, we can configure, we can rectify any issues will comes, any failures will come, we can rectify that easily. Okay. The fourth this stuff in the DCT, that is data center technology, the fourth stuff is remote operation and maintenance. So remote operations and maintenance is talking about remotely. If you see in the left hand side, if you have a remote oriented, it is a global one, we can make some easily, like the operation management, analytics, and we can generate the reports, budgeting, the LDAP, that is already have discussed, maybe in the data warehousing, data mining concept, SLP integration, we can easily monitor, schedule the policies, auditing, recommendations, all this sort of things, task we can easily done with the help of remote. Coming to this one, most of the operational and administrative tasks, whatever just now we have task means, operation management to recommendation, these are all called as administrative tasks. All these are called as administrative tasks of IT resources in data centers, or commanded. Commanded means we can control through the network's remote consoles and management systems. So technical persons are not required here, without any technical persons, to visit the dedicated rooms and house servers, except to perform highly specific tasks. They can visit the big servers. Other than that, there is no need of any technical persons to handle these situations. Okay, that is the remote operations and management. Simply, we can call this topic talks about remote operation management. Administrative tasks, whatever we have, without any technical persons, until unless it's a complex issue, until unless we can easily done all this sort of task, which is shown in the figure, the task in the sense. Coming to the next 5, 6, 7, that is high availability, security aware design, operations and maintenance, management and facilities. All this, let me see one after the other. So this is the 5th step we are going to be talking about, and this is the 6th step, and this is the 7th one. Now let me talk about the first one, high availability. High availability in the sense, like when any load has come into that one. See, for example, many times we have discussed this example. Whenever you are getting any competitive exams have written and results came into picture, now when you making accessing the same website, then it is a maybe for example for your AP MCET or maybe for your results previously, when you are accessing the same website, more burden. So at that time, we have to get some highly availability of access, or any failure of the things has done immediately, we have to replace with the existing one. So data center outage significantly impacts business continuity. Hence, they are designed to operate with increasingly higher levels of redundancy to sustain availability. So this highly availability can anticipate of system failures. Any sudden failures or come along with any communication links or cluster hardware for load balancing, we can use this high availability. So the main target of this feature is any failure, sudden failures or came into picture, or any communication problems or any technical issues will come, or any more load has to come into that one, then immediately it has to be act by highly availability. And the next 6th one, that is secure aware design, operations and management, 6th stuff of this DCT is secure aware. In the sense, the name itself, security aware design, physical and logical access controls. Because you are dealing with a data center, definitely it is easily accessed by that. So frequently we are observing that Facebook accounts have hacked by 1 million Facebook accounts are hacked, or some Twitter accounts are hacked, or some sort of things we are observing. And sometimes we are seeing that somebody have created a fake profile. Please don't transfer any money. Such type of ads we are observing that. Because of not a good secure aware design to operate on management, definitely this type of problems will come into picture. So that's why the physical and logical access control and data recovery strategies need to be thorough and comprehensive for data centers, since they are centralized structures. As we discussed in the starting of that, this DCT is a house centralized. House centralized means it is a single point access that store and process business data. Because of that, we have to take care of more secure. The design, the architecture is very clearly have more securely has to design it. Outsourcing data center based IT resources. Outsourcing in the sense from the third party, from the different cloud providers, outsourcing have been a common industry practice for decades, and outsourcing models often require long-term consumer commitment. So this is also a very big challenge, because most of the providers are coming to picture. Maybe they are going to be misusing that information which is collected from the cloud consumer. We don't know exactly. So we have some trusted third parties, trusted cloud providers, so that we can access easily. We can share our sensitive data. Very important is the sensitive data. Hacking in the sense, not user ID password. Other than that, we have some sort of sensitive data, like we have personal data will be there. That also very important to do that. The 7th one, facilities. In this DCT, the 7th stuff is facilities. So facilities are custom design locations. The facilities are, like as I said, we have different regions. When you are doing the experiment of the EC2, we have different regions from Virginia, from different places, right? Have several functional layout areas, as well as several power supplies, cabling, and environment control stations that regulate heating, and we have to take care of the heating, ventilations, air conditions, fire protection, and other related subsystems. We have to use some sort of to maintain, because to maintaining this DCT is that much not easy, because only in the lab for normal desktop systems, we are continuously going off ACs, right, to make cool of that system so that we can be have problem. Or else in the ATM machines also, for every one or two machines, they're having minimum one or two ACs going to be operating continuously. It is going to be flowing continuously, because to make sort of give some facility easily can access. If you have any problem or any heating problems are there, definitely there is a problems of fluctuations, or maybe have hanging of the systems. All such type of problems can be avoided. Only for desktops, we are taking that much of care and think about that how we had to take care of the data center, which consisting of big servers, and they have lot heating power consumption over there. To cool that, we requires all such type of facilities, such as I said, you the power supply, cabling, environment control, as well as the ventilation, air condition, fire protection, and other subsystems is required. And coming to the next stuff of this DCT is computing hardware. The name itself talks about computing hardware. When we have a hardware, like to access, somebody can have computing that, how much it is required, how much of the power consumption, storage capacity is left it, how much of the RAM is left it, how we can allocate it to which user, which consumer we have to allocate it. All sorts of things we can be maintained in this one. If you see in the left-hand side, as we have no different services out there, IaaS, the PaaS, and as application as a service, to access this one from anywhere, from maybe from laptops we can access, or from desktop we can access these services, or from tablets we can access, or from phones also we can access. And most roughly, to access all this one, where it is accessing is from the major, that is servers, that is DCTs. Now inside that, we have some sort of the task like monitoring, content, collaboration, communication, finance, etc. All the available tasks inside. So these features, which is a cloud, all these are the three features, example is showing here, can access from all the four different devices through help of DCT, that is servers. Now, if you see at the right-hand side, rack mount from factor servers designed composed of the standardized racks with the interconnects for power or network or cooling, and support different hardware processing architectures, such as we can have x86 32 bits, x86 64, or maybe RISC architectures. Maybe all this RISC architecture has studied in COA, that is computer organization and architectures, I think. We have a course, right? So a power efficiency, multi-core CPU architectures that houses hundreds of processing cores. In the same servers, we have different cores, hundreds of cores in a space as small as single unit standardized racks. Racks in the sense like RISC, RISC, we have some sort of racks, right? Disk racks we are going to keeping over there. Most of you have observed in the maybe some videos how the data centers it look like. It is having redundant hard swappable components like such as the hard disk, power supplies, network interface, storage control cords, all will be available inside this computing hardware. Okay, and the next stuff is storage hardware. The ninth stuff over in the DCT is storage hardware. So as the previous one is a computing hardware, this is storage. So it deals mostly on storages. So how full, how when any of the capacity is full, how we can overcome the problem, how the digital information can be have with the help of different references we can use. And see the right left-hand side, we have, this is a cloud storage. We have like the storages like NoSQL, RDBMS, or we can have the NFSC, or we can have disk replica, or maybe some different storages capacities we are having. Based on our requirement, we can access any storage, right? So previously we have done with, MySQL, I think. We have done with RDS experiment, right? So storage systems or containers, it is available, housing numerous hard disks that are organized into arrays. Which one we required, we can access that. And the next is the 10th stuff of this DCT is network hardware. So previously, just now discussed about the computing, storage, and the third one is networking. So in networking, we can have deals with the levels of connectivity. If you see the figure closely, see, this is the internet. The step one, from the internet, with the help of the firewall, we are making some routings with the help of the fiber. So accessing from this, the already you are aware, AP fiber is also be going on. So it is accessing from the servers, fiber server. And through this one, we have different switches everywhere to access that one, maybe through the laptop or through the television or through the smartphone or maybe any tablets or all any sort of things we can access. So throughout this, to access from a server, from a like example of fiber servers, to access that one, we are using some networking switches like the routers or switches or maybe hubs to access maybe different devices such as the PC, laptop, desktop, or phone. To access that one, we can use this network hardware. Now, data center is broken down into 5 network subsystems like carrier and external network interconnections, web tier load balancing and accelerations, LAN fabric, SAN fabric, NAS fabric. That is LAN, already are aware, local area networks, storage area networks, and network going to be accessed throughout. How good we can access that all, this LAN, SAN, NAS. Not only that, we can also have some external interconnections, which is shown clearly in the figure, like workstations. If you observe in the figure, the workstation also be, we can access this external network interconnection. And web tier load balancing and accelerations also we can access, right? So here. And the last stuff of this DCT is the other consideration. Not only all, just now we had discussed about the different features and components of the data center technology. The last stuff over this here is the last one, other consideration. Rapid technological obsolescences with life cycles that typically last between the 5 to 7 years. This hardware, every time we need to be make some rapid changes, because as the consumers or more to access that one. Initially, the consumers will be very less for the single cloud provider. Say, for example, initially for the WhatsApp, maybe 100 or 1,000 or 10,000, 1 lakh users. Now, currently, it is going on in the millions of millions, right? So, rapidly, we have changes has to come in the IT hardware. As well as security is another major issue, as I discussed you, because we are dealing with the sensitive data. Definitely, we required in the cloud security is a major challenging, research challenge is going on in the market, where to provide very secure for accessing of this. So that's why it is going to have three layer security, or any, like we have OTP type of security, or to access that one, some different the things we are going to observe. Even you're logging in another system, your Gmail, it is asking that from your Samsung mobile or from your mobile, please give accept as click on as such type of security things they are going to be dealing. So that's about the topic. DCT, what we have discussed is, we have discussed about the virtualization, we have discussed about the standardization, modularity, we have discussed about the automation, remote operation and management, high availability, secure aware of all this, secure aware design, operations and management, facilities, computing hardware, storage hardware, network hardware, and other considerations we have discussed in this topic. So that's about the DCT.